This is a production of PBS 39.
Not far from the Adult Literacy Center in Allentown, students head to class at the Baum School of Art. A local jewelry maker's part of a new group of people turning their passions into profit. Crystal Fisher tells us more.
I used to work with stainless steel, copper, and iron, and now I switched to silver, gold, and platinum.
For some reason, when I started doing beadwork, it just sang to me.
I like the magic of fire and silver together. It's really alchemy.
You have such a short time on this earth. Why not, you know, at least spend part of that time doing something that you really enjoy?
Ann Biernat Rucker and her friends at Allentown's Baum School love making jewelry.
You know, I enjoy taking the classes at the Baum School, but there's a limited amount of time there, so I wanted to be able to create things at home.
Stealing moments to sift through fashion magazines for inspiration, and sneaking time at the end of the day, Anne began to string her hobby into her home life.
When everyone is, you know, thinking about going to bed, that's kind of when I get started thinking about what I'm going to work on my jewelry.
Anne's basement began to overflow with jewelry, and her husband warned her people might be getting a little tired of getting necklaces for Christmas. So she turned to the Baum School again for creative ways to get her hobby out to the world.
As I met other jewelry artists at the Baum School and through other sources, I realized that many of them don't have the marketing expertise that I do.
Anne created a website so local jewelers in her classes could showcase and sell their art.
She wanted to share her marketing ability for those of us that don't have that marketing ability.
There are not many venues by which local artists from Lehigh Valley specifically can express their work unless they're into a gallery.
11 students and teachers from the Baum School take advantage of Anne's site, hoping to make their hobbies profitable. Anne takes what she knows about creating and managing a website from her day job.
It's something that I know how to do as far as, you know, putting things on the web and taking the photographs and writing the copy.
Bluestem offers visibility. It also offers a really wonderful social aspect when we get together.
Not only does the site offer a place to sell jewelry, but Anne also hosts get-togethers on the weekends for artists to meet and talk about their work. With all the positive feedback she kept getting from the Bluestem designers, Anne decided to open the site to other area artists. Surfing the internet for bargain supplies, Emily Kitt stumbled across Anne's post on Craigslist. She brings a spunky new vibe.
Bluestem is a fantastic outlet. It's a whole bunch of artists together. All of us have different styles. If I'm sitting in front of a desk with a torch and a hammer, I'm happy.
She melts the past life out of the metal, saws off the unnecessary edges, and pounds out the rough ridges. Emily draws inspiration from things she finds in her everyday life.
Just recently I found some broken pieces of plate in my backyard from its really cool, kitschy, like 50s design.
Turning knickknacks into necklaces, her addition of recycled art marks the beginning of a new chapter for bluestemstudio.biz.
I like to grow from the 12 artists we have now to 20.
But having marketing deadlines during the day and keeping up with the website at night takes a lot of Anne's time.
My jewelry tends to go on the back burner, my designing jewelry. I get wrapped up in the website.
With the help of Anne's husband, who prepares food for their lunches, and the dedication of the group, Bluestem Studio artists hope to follow their passion all the way to the bank. For Tempo, I'm Crystal Fisher reporting.